Good evening, welcome to UKO Boxing TV with me, Phil Barnett, here at Wednesbury Boxing Academy. Joining me tonight, we have Matt Gordon, West Bromwich Heavyweight, Lennox Clarke, Halesowen Middleweight, and Paul Mann, trainer, agony uncle, father figure, and the boss round here. Matt, start to you. How's training going? Second pro fight coming up. How was your first one? What have you learned from it?
Training's going well. I've took it up. I'm doing a lot of power and resistance work, getting the strength building up, swimming. It's going really well, to be honest.
Did you obviously had your first 5 points win over James Oliphant? How did that go? How was the buzz?
It went well. Like the opening rounds, I thought went really well. It was going my way. Paul. It was in my corner, he told me to take it down, slow it down a bit, which I found it hard to struggle with, probably just it being the first of my my pro debut. But these are things what I'm fixing in my training now, just getting more relaxed and being able to deal with all the pressure of the crowd and the ticket sales and whatever else. But yeah, I enjoyed it a lot.
What is the buzz like when you... I think you saw about 160 tickets
for. Oh, yeah, the buzz was amazing. Like my crowd did me proud that day. Like it was really loud, and they kept me going through the last round, which I got a little bit tired in due to like a lot of work and not being able to slow down. It was amazing feeling, and I love it.
Obviously, you're back out on the October 3rd Black Country Boxing Show at Walsall Town Hall. How's preparation going for that? It's obviously getting pretty close to it now.
Yeah, it's pretty close, and I'm feeling confident. I'm peaking. I'm where I want to be, so I'm happy. I'm happy with how it's going. Really happy.
How are you getting on with combining training for pro fights? And like you say, there is that pressure on you, but you're obviously running your own business as well at the same time.
Yeah, luckily, because I'm working for myself, and like my business partners really support me a lot. I find it easy to, juggle the time. If I have a personal training session at 8 o'clock in the morning, I'm normally at work for like 9:30, which isn't too bad. And then I'll start my boxing training at about 4:30. So really, it's just give and take a little bit, but I've got a lot of support around me, which helps with that.
What's happening with an opponent? I know you did have an opponent. He seems to have pulled out.
I'm yet to hear myself what's happening with the opponent. I'm not really too bothered, to be honest. I'm just sticking on my game anyway. It would have been nice to know who it was, have a quick look at it, how they box, but I'm confident that I'm on top of my game and I'm going to bring exactly what I'm training on in the gym.
Lennox, obviously your 8 fights into your career, you're just moving up and levelling your next fight, which we'll touch on in a minute. Can you appreciate where Matt is? Obviously, it's not so long ago, it was only a couple of years ago that you were in a similar position, sort of one fight in and learning your way.
Yeah, he's just getting used to the programme and adapting to the different styles and, as he said, pacing himself and getting used to being under the pressure of selling tickets and everything else that comes with it. But yeah, he'll soon grasp it and get used to what he needs to do.
It's a fact with both of them. It's the pressure of the tickets. These are both big ticket sellers. So the pressure I understand from both of them. I mean, the way he boxed, the way he performs when he trains is totally different. And with him, you seen him when he was on the match room show. It wasn't the best performance on himself. He won though. And they put so much pressure on themselves, these kids do. They work, they sell tickets. Boxing's not an easy sport, as you know. And there's a fit training in between it as well. And he runs his own business. He does his own business. And it's very, very hard. So I'm quite proud where they are, man, to tell the truth. He's done really, really well, both of them are fantastic, especially Matt. He was in bits on his first fight. I mean, there's a lot of tickets, yeah. And it's just small. I mean, Lennox sold, I think, 300-400 when he fought in the match room, first boxing show. He's got his own room. I mean, we've done it. We've had 3 British titles, we've done world titles, we've done everything. Germany, world title, women's, everything. So we know the pressure, but these kids are coming along. And I think they're performing fantastic, I do. Really, really good. Onwards and upwards, guys.
Nice one.
What did you make of, from a technical point of view, from a trainer's point of view, what did you make of that?
I think the main thing is a lot of the training is very, very important for recovery. It's important. You've got to train, but a lot of it's in the mind. And that all shows when they go to the ring, they've had the fight, they're having the fight, and then they think they're losing, but a lot of it's got to do with nerves. So I already know the shaking of the legs and say, oh, I've been training so hard, my legs feel like jelly. But that's all to do with adrenaline and the pressure on them for all the crowd there and their first show, and especially being on television and things like that. It's like this interview now. They get dry mouth and everything like that. We're used to it. You do it day in, day out, and that's happened. So I'm very, very proud the way they handle themselves in and outside the ring. Yeah, good performance, guys.
Do you already feel less nervous, Matt, about your second fight now that you know a bit more what to expect?
Yeah, I've kind of been here before. Like, obviously, when I first started boxing in the unlicensed game, and I see it a lot, like, with lads in the gym, like, when they're first, when they have their first fights. And the main thing I say is, like, just stay relaxed and stay calm. And it's basically what I never did myself. Like, it's so easily done, and I know that. And I proved it on my debut, like.
Tell me a bit more about that background in the unlicensed fighting. You went for the sort of white-collar unlicensed route rather than the amateur route. Just tell us how you...
Yeah, obviously, like, because... Well, say, like, starting 8 years ago, I started off in the MMA game, but I suffered a shoulder injury, which had me out for, like, 9 months. When I got back, I could box, but I couldn't wrestle. So I come to a boxing gym, and I never looked back, really. I love boxing, and I thought I'd wasted my time in the MMA gym. So from there, that's where I progressed. And I kind of forgot what the question was.
A lot of people come from the unlicensed now.
Oh, yeah.
It's not before we had it was like amateur. There's a lot of children coming through and they'd have the amateur background, you have your experience, they come through and they come to the boxing gym. And when it comes to professional and amateur boxing, they say, what's the difference? The difference, you plant your feet, it's a lot harder. It's not a point scoring system. There's a lot more knockouts, so they stand their ground and they fight. And these kids are coming through, but now they're coming through from an unlicensed background. So we have to start teaching as well. We have to get them to get all their mistakes right, which they don't have to do the amateur background. And that's why it's very impressive what they've achieved, coming from no amateur background, just coming from, say, from unlicensed as fighters. But they've got that thing, they've got that fight in them. The fight, that's the thing that we can't. You can teach them all the training, all the techniques, but it's the fight to carry on. And once you start going past the three rounds, and you've got four rounds, then you've got six rounds, eight rounds, Lennox has gone for his title and he's done them rounds. So, yeah, very, very impressive now. Some of the kids that were going through, I mean, I was a bit unsettled when they was first coming through. Some of the unlicensed lads, I was a bit worried, like, they haven't had the amateur background. But the way some of these kids are performing, it's fantastic.
I think there's a lot of that as well. Like, yeah. It's a little bit frowned upon. Some people think that, we don't really deserve to be in here coming from an unlicensed with no amateur background. So that's what we're here to do. We're training hard. I mean, we're here to prove everybody wrong, we do deserve to be in here.
Lennox, you came from the same sort of background.
Yeah.
Do you think, in a way, unlicensed boxing prepares you better for pro boxing because it's a bit rougher, because you haven't got head guards like you have in the amateurs, you haven't got massive gloves like you've got in the amateurs?
Yeah, I mean, you could say so. I mean, it's a completely different style, as Paul says. It's more of a fight rather than amateurs is point scoring, so it probably does get us more used to not wearing head guards and used to the programme, yeah.
This is why in the amateurs now, they've actually got rid of the head guards to attract more people, because the unlicensed is, it's very, very popular. There's people that don't, there's normal business people that just go there to fight, but these kids actually went to the next level, and they says, look, we're going to go to there, we're going to prove that we can do, because there's so much potential. We've got another lad who's fighting soon, Mohammed Zabo, and he's another one coming from the license, got other lads coming through unlicensed, and they are, I mean, even though I used to be like that, because I remember it from the day, I never used to agree with it, but as long as, if they're coming in and they're willing to go into that paid rank, and they've got to sell all them tickets, and have all that pressure, and they're willing to do it, fair play to the kids, and they are proving really good. They're sticking to the gym, they're training two times a day, every single day. They're doing their diets now correctly. They're all weights on it. So, professional. They're saying professional outside, inside the ring. It's really, really good.
And that's it. I turn professional just for the love of the sport. Like, it's not really about the money for me. Like, journeymen in the unlicensed make decent money weekly. They can box on the Friday and the Saturday. It's not about that. It's about the love of the sport, why I decided to turn professional. And, I did box quite a few. I always box away, and whoever was there to box, I boxed them and I was beating them. So that's another reason why I turned over.
Do you find it helps with the ticket sales as well, because you've been out there, you're getting your name out there, you've already got a bit of a following, and when you turn pro, you can sort of build on that already?
Yeah, I mean, I was selling 60 tickets for the unlicensed. So as soon as I turned pro, like, that doubled instantly. Mm. People was thinking, wow, he's actually doing it. Like, is he really that good? Can he do it? And I've done it. So my ticket sales have just, each fight have been just gradually getting more and more. And now where I am now, I'm hoping to sell 400 for this fight coming up now. So they keep growing, yeah.
Most of my fights was away in the unlicensed game. I never used to fight at home. So, and I won most of them.
Interesting stuff, chaps. We'll reconvene after the break. Join us in a minute for part two. Black sea is flashing lights. Black sea is flashing lights. Welcome back to UKO Boxing TV. We're here with heavyweight Matt Gordon, middleweight Lennox Clarke, trainer Paul Mann. Chaps, thanks again for your time. Lennox, let's talk about you. 8-0, perfect professional record so far. You've got to step up October 17th against Craig Cunning.
Yeah. I'm fighting for the Midlands title on the 17th of October at the NIA, Barclaycard Arena, against Craig Cunningham. Like, I've got nothing against him, but it's the route I want to take in boxing. I want to take the local area belt, then I want to climb to the English and so on, and take all the bouts in order. So if that means I have to get through Craig Cunningham, that's what I'm going to do. Yeah.
What you say, you're fighting on a big show, the big Birmingham show, the big Matchroom show. It's the second time you've done it, and your last fight, obviously, that was your first sort of big venue. How was that? How was the experience of it? I spoke to you afterwards. I remember you said you were a bit sort of tightly wound up in there.
Yeah, I mean, like, it didn't really go the way I wanted it to go. I got the win, but in my worst way. I mean, there's a number of things that you could put down to it, but I'm not going to, like, make any excuses up. It was just a bad day in the office for me. But I still got a W, so that's all that matters. We won, so. But yeah, I mean, I've been on the big stage now, like, under the big lights and in front of that many people, which is a new experience. I've done that now. So I can just focus on Craig Cunningham now and just dealing with him, rather than dealing with the pressure of being in front of the lights, yeah.
We talked before, obviously, about Matt and his debut, and now he's coming into his second fight. I guess you touched on it there about that. You're going to have that sort of nerves and that pressure stepping up from, you know, before Walsall Town Hall.
Yeah.
A couple of fights, some sort of hotel room bills and that sort of thing. And there is that pressure there when you're fighting in front of, like, sort of 10 times the number of people that you're fighting in front of before.
Yeah, it's a big step. Like, it's a completely different atmosphere when you're in there. So, yeah, it's just one step to another and getting used to two different atmospheres. But I mean, I'm going to do it, and I mean, I'm going to get the win in good style. So, oh, that's it. Yeah.
Obviously, televised. It's, you know, involved with Matchroom and Eddie Hearn, and that. Does that give you that taste of how far you can go?
Yeah, it gives me that hunger to know that I'm on the edge now. After this fight, it's going to put me where I need to be. It's going to put my name out there. People all over the country in the boxing are going to know about me after this fight. Yeah.
So tell me a bit about this kid, Paul.
He's a good kid. He's done well. He's unbeaten. He's a really good kid. Nice kid. But there's I don't want to say too much and make his head be like this, but I've got a lot of faith in Lennox. He trains, he's dedicated, and he can punch. He can punch. He's got a natural punch here. I mean, he can really whack. And also, he's got the speed as well. He just kind of just gels. If I do any pad work with him, he just memorises it. I show him once and he's like a sponge. He just soaks it like water. Anything I tell him, he just remembers. So I'm hoping, I don't speak out of turn or anything, but I think this kid will do very well. No pressure. I'm hoping. And Matt as well. They're very dedicated. And I'm not undermining Matt by saying this, just so that Lennox is fighting for this big title. And I do believe, I personally believe, the same way their camp believes in their fighters, and we've had fighters, I mean, even though we've won 3 British titles, we've had that many number of times we fought for the British title, European, we've done everything, IBF title, world title eliminator, there's not been Martin Gethin. I'm always, as any other trainer should be, is totally 100% confident in their fighter, and this kid is someone that I think will go very, very far. And that's coming from an unlicensed background, but having the discipline as a professional, inside and outside the ring, that's what I believe.
Talk us through, from a trainer's point of view, the fight with Cunningham, because I think Lennox would have admit himself, obviously Alistair Warren was a tough fighter in that in that last one, but he's coming up against, I mean, it's the first fight you've boxed that's got a winning record.
What do you make of him? He's a southpaw and he's a good counterpunch, as most southpaws are. I don't want to say too much because he gives too much away, but it'll just be a very, very good fight, because if you, as you know, you've seen all of Lennox's fights, they're not boring fights. They're crowd-pleasing fights. He goes for it and he goes for the win. So I'm not going to give any of our secrets away or anything, but there's no secrets. He'll just adapt to whatever situation comes there, which he does brilliant. I mean, he's a South. We could go in there and turn orthodox. He adapts. And that's something that you can't teach. You can't teach every kid to do that. Some kids have just got it. This kid's got this natural ability. Whatever comes to the table, whatever he brings, he'll adapt to that. And I'm sure we'll be successful.
How'd you get on with southpaws, then?
Well, obviously, like...
Like I said, you adapt to every situation, so you're fine.
I mean, I'm getting used to it. I'm getting used to the southpaw stance now. I'm getting used to how their punches are coming at me, which is obviously different to orthodox. But yeah, like come 17th of October, I'd have nailed the southpaw stance and he'll be in for a hard night. Yeah.
Let's have a little look at Lennox in action, then we'll come back and have another chat. Do you know Craig Cunningham? Personally, have you come across him on the scene? Obviously, he's a local lad, it's a local derby.
Yeah, I mean, I've sparred him before. I've had some good spars, but like, I don't want to take too much out of sparring, because come fight night, it's different. I mean, I've got nothing against him, apart from he's holding my belt for me. And I'll be taking that belt come that night, and that's what I need to move on in my career. So he's got to know I'm coming for his belt, so that's it, yeah.
There's mutual respect between them. There's no hatred. But when it comes to a fight, it's a fight game. It's where they want to go in their careers. So on both parts, I mean, but this kid, he's training like it's his world title, which he's done with every fight, and that's why he's got success. So we might do that as well. There's nothing they've got against. There's none of that. The way that animosity starts within boxing and all the hate and the love relationship to sell the fight, doesn't need to do that. Doesn't need to do that. This kid performs in every fight, so he doesn't need to say that he hates him or this or that. He just wants, he's going to win. And that's what he wants to do. That's what he trains for. That's the main thing with him.
And I guess, you know, people that know boxing around here will want to see the fight because it is a close fight. It's a local fight. It doesn't need too much.
Well, no, I think Lennox.
Well, it's going to be a competitive fight, and I know that. You know what I mean? It's going to be my hardest test yet. But like, it's what I need, and I'm willing. I'm willing to step up, and you know, I will step up. So, yeah, it's going to be interesting come the night.
Talk to me a bit about the rest of that show, because obviously the good thing about, we don't know yet where on the bill you're going to be, but then you'd probably be pretty close to the fights that are after. We've got some exciting fights with obviously a couple more local lads.
Well, derbies.
Jason Welborn is your
fantastic
mate.
Sam Egerton, Frankie Gavin, superb. And we've got Sam Egerton's done. It's fantastic, the kids. You know, and Frankie Gavin, mutual respect for both of them. Fantastic bill. Jason Welborn, who as you know is managed by Errol. Errol never comes in front of the television, but Errol is the boss.
He'll be critiquing after, don't worry.
Jason Welborn, fantastic kid. What a fight he's got, Macklin. And then obviously, Lennox, and then we have got another kid who's just come on the scene now, Zach Box, who's also on that bill as well. It's going to be a really, really, really good show. I believe it will, because of the local derbies and obviously the crowd and everything. I think all the crowd will be behind that. So these that will get on their Facebook and Twitter accounts, and so everyone that wants to buy tickets, hurry up, because they're nearly all sold out. I think
this is a chance to get your plug in, boys. Yeah, how do people contact you for tickets?
Yeah, I mean, you can get me on Facebook at Lennox Leon. I've got tickets, or you can contact UKO Boxing and speak to Dan Molan. You'll have to get your tickets from there.
Matt, you're just getting involved in the social media aspects of things. How do people get the tickets from you? I know you've already sold a lot.
Yeah, the best way is through Facebook, Matt Gordon. Or I've got a page actually we can like as well, Matt Gordon, Black Prince. So.
Fantastic. Let's just get some predictions. I want to ask you about the fights that we've just been touching on. Obviously, Jason Wellborn is one of your boys. We thought he was going to fight Sam Eggington. Frankie Gavin got that fight instead. Yeah. Then Jason's gone up two divisions to fight Matthew Macklin, the former world title challenger.
Jason's one of them. He's hit and miss. He's just one of them. The kids, I mean, I've got a lot of respect for the kid. I hope he does it. And it's a tough test, but if Jason's on his game, he'll give anyone a tough match. If he's been trained the way he has, again, like I said, he's my fighter.
Tell me then, Wellborn or Macklin?
You know I'm going to go for Wellborn.
You're going to say Wellborn, Yeah. The main event, Frankie Gavin against Eggington. Just give me a name.
I can't give you a name there, mate. It's horrible.
I can't really. I'm a Sam fan. Sam Eggington. Like, he's from down the road. Smevic, young lad. I like the way he's come, you know, the way he's hard, he's a grafter. I like him.
Well, at least you gave me an answer, mate. Chaps, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Good luck in your fights, and we'll talk to you again soon.
Brilliant, thank you.
Thanks very much for watching UKO Boxing TV. We'll see you again next time. Like sea is flashing light.